parents are a formidable force, as we should be. We are forming and raising the next generation of people who will lead our country. Every single generation has the opportunity in the United States to take the United States in one direction or the other, to make it better than it was when it was handed to them, or to degrade it and to make it worse. We as parents have a responsibility to form our children into responsible stewards of the greatest experiment in liberty the world has ever known. That's a serious responsibility. And every single parent, Democrat or Republican, understands what it means to raise the next generation, to protect their children from evil. And they don't trust the schools or the school system, and they shouldn't. In the state of Indiana, by the way, in their public school system, claims that critical race theory is not being taught in schools. They say it's not an issue here. Parents, go home, settle down, be quiet. Nothing to see here. We don't teach this. You know, don't bother us. But a teacher in the state of Indiana is exposing the critical race theory that is absolutely 100% unequivocally taught in public schools in this state. And it is absolutely chilling. Take a listen to this.
I'm the science coach and admin in the largest public school district in Indiana. I'm in dozens of classrooms a week, so I see exactly what we're teaching our students. When we tell you that schools aren't teaching critical race theory, that it's nowhere in our standards, that's misdirection. We don't have the quotes and theories as state standards per se. We do have critical race theory in how we teach. We tell our teachers to treat students differently based on color. We tell our students that every problem is a result of white men, and that everything Western civilization built is racist. Capitalism as a tool of white supremacy. Those are straight out of Kimberly Crenshaw's main points, verbatim, in Critical Race Theory, the writings that formed the movement. This is in math, history, science, English, the arts, and it's not slowing down. If students of color have lower reading scores, it's because of inequity. Therefore, we take from the white students and give to the color students. That's Richard Delgado, straight out of CRT in Introduction. All teaching is political, with reality and facts taking the back seat. That's Dr. Gloria Ladson-Billings, who outlined how she saw critical race theory flushed out in public schools in 1995. When schools tell you that we aren't teaching critical race theory, it means one thing. Go away and look into our affairs no further. It isn't about transparency, it isn't about cultural relevance. It's race essentialism, painted to look like the district cares about students of color. We call it anti-racism, so you feel bad if you disagree with our segregationist pedagogy. It's taking advantage of kids' vulnerability and parents' inactivity to preen over social snake oil schemes designed to create division. Parents, when we tell you critical race theory isn't taught in our schools, we're lying. Keep looking.
When we say we're not teaching critical race theory, we are lying. Keep looking. Truer words were never spoken. The Democrats are messing with the wrong parents. The wrong parents who don't want their children to be racist. They don't want their children to be told that they're racist based on the color of their skin, or told that they're the victims of racism based on the color of their skin. It's simply false. You mess with these parents, you will see a backlash. You will see school boards being taken over by parents. Representatives who accept money from these very far left, extreme teachers unions being voted out, as they should be. In Fairfax County in Virginia, we're lucky, by the way, that Youngkin won in Virginia. But the fight there is not even close to over. In Fairfax County, there's a questionnaire that's being handed out to middle schooler and high schoolers. This means children as young as 12 years old. 12 years old. And on this questionnaire, they claim it's not mandatory, but still, it's being handed to your 12-year-old. It asks them if they are transgender. It asks them about their sex life. These are the questions on the questionnaire. Quote, some people describe themselves as transgender when their sex at birth does not match the way they think or feel about their gender. Are you transgender? Which of the following best describes you? Heterosexual, gay or lesbian, bisexual, not sure. Have you ever had sexual intercourse? How old were you when you had sexual intercourse the first time? During your life, with how many people have you had sexual intercourse? During the last 3 months, with how many people have you had sexual intercourse? The last time you had sexual intercourse, did you or your partner use a condom? Have you ever had oral sex? What would you do? This is not a rhetorical question. What would you do if your 12-year-old brought this home from school and said, Mom, Dad, this was handed to me by my teacher. This is what I'm being told to fill out. The Democrats and the radical leftists are messing with the wrong people, messing with parents. This radical sex agenda, it's essentially not critical race theory, it's critical gender theory, trying to disassociate sex from marriage, disassociate sex from God, disassociate sex from commitment and love and procreation. in Vermont. There was a state law signed last year by Governor Phil Scott. This is what the state law says. Schools are required to provide information about proper condom use that is inclusive of gender identity, sexuality, and ethnicity in an effort to prevent or reduce unintended pregnancies and sexually transmitted diseases. What does this mean? This means that 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th graders in the state of Vermont, in every public school in the state of Vermont, are being given free condoms. The Democrats and the radical left are messing with the wrong people. They're messing with parents, and parents don't want this. Parents might put up with violations of liberty, with radical leftist ideology being hurled at them, with the government trying to act as big brother when it's aimed at them. But when it's aimed at their kids, just you wait. What we saw in Virginia will be nothing compared to the backlash that we're going to see if Democrats keep coming for our kids. If Democrats keep coming for our kids, especially with vaccine mandates. Parents are the wrong people to mess with. And we are, as parents, as moms and dads, grandmas and grandpas, we should be the wrong people to mess with. Because it's our responsibility to protect our kids from this evil ideology that the radical left is trying to pour into our little kids' minds.